G'day, I'm Clive and welcome to CDP Outdoors. Back on the Bibbulmun track and I'm heading to Gringer Creek. Let's go and have a look. Made it to Gringer Creek. Where's the sign for it? Up there. Some people call it Gringer, others call it Gringer. You choose. It's a lovely, how can I put it? It's got a prehistoric look here with all the grass trees. It's fantastic out there. Okay, so next up. This one's had an extension, so we've got a retainer wall here with seating around, with the fire pit in front still. They've added some steps down and the picnic bench out the front. And what they've actually extended is here. You see all the new wood, and you get to the darker wood of the original. And now we've got a picnic bench and the shelves are in the extended bit. We've got the bunks either side and the platform going across, and this one sleeps, looking at it, between 12 and 15 at a squeeze. We have your box with your logging books in there. So you always check in then, you write down the date, where you started, where you're heading to, how long you expect to be out, if you're in a group or that sort of stuff. So if anything happens, they can check the books and see who's heading where, and if they haven't arrived at the next shelter, they know to search in between. So there's your safety bit. Water tanks. We've got one on either side. And remember, with the water, it's rain water, it's not on the mains, so only use what you need, don't waste it. And on the side of the shelter here on the outside, they've got the broom and the rake, so you can keep the shelter clean, rake all the pea gravel, make it tidy, get rid of all your rubbish, sweep all your decks, all that sort of thing. Just be respectful that other people are going to be here after you. Okay, picnic spots then, your tent pitches, up this way. Let's go explore. Oh, there's the spider web, gone now, it's still on me. I'll check in a bit. I don't know, one of those strands that go across. Really strong they are. And this is a long walk to the tent pitches. Let's keep going, shall we? Now the track splits up. Goes up that way. Which I think they've made because it goes towards the dunny. And here's the first tent pitch here. Now, size wise, when I say one will fit on there, I'm using a standard or the average two person hiking tent. So on this one, half what you can see with the pea gravel is coming down the slope, and the top half is fairly level. So you're only really going to fit one on there, one tent. And if you're using a tent on these, always use a ground sheet or a footprint to your tent to protect the bottom of it so it lasts longer. And with your pea gravel, if you've got a decent sleep mat, you'll have a comfortable night. You will, no trouble. Now here's another one. This one looks like it's big enough for two tents on here. So you've got a level over here, and then it drops a bit, and you've got another level over here. That's a decent one. Look at the views you get from these tent pictures. I don't know if you can hear on the audio at the moment, but because we're so close to Albany Highway and the North Bannister Junction down here, where you've got the where the old roadhouse used to be, it's just a fuel station and a small shop now, which is about a 20-minute walk, 15-20 minutes straight down the trail opposite the shelter. And here's another tent pitch. Again, comfortably you'll get one on here. I think it'll be difficult to put a squeeze on two. But yeah, you got the pea gravel around. And remember, it's a decent pegs because north of the track, the ground seems to be a lot harder and it just softens up the further south you go. So that's 1, 2, 3 tent pitches was that. Let's go and see where the other track went that came up. Okay, here we go. That's the other tent pitch. Now I think it's going to go up to the Dunny, so we'll head there unless we see another tent pitch on the way. Your Dunny, which is your toilet. They're drop toilets, composting. So, no wet wipes down there because the wet wipes will destroy the compost. And when your composting is destroyed, you get flies and maggots and it starts to stink. No chemicals, because again, chemicals are going to destroy the compost. And ladies, when it's that time of the month, you're going to need to take that back out with you, because that will destroy the compost in the toilets. And like I said, there's no mains water, so it's just all rainwater coming from the roof of the shelter. Yeah, this little track off, I think it's just because it's been used to get back on the actual Bibbulmun track, walking into the Dunny. It's created a track. But here's your Dunny, your toilet. Up at top. We'll be carrying up there. That's your Bibbulmun track. So here's your toilet, your drop toilet. And that's it, that's all your toilet is. That's all you need, a lid, a seat, and the drop toilet itself. There is toilet paper and spare up there, but don't guarantee there will be any because it's not meant to be provided. It's the trail angels and other hikers when they're coming through. They'll leave one behind if they're not going any further or if they've got too many. But this is your view, your loo with a view. Look at that, hey? Okay, let's go and have a look what's on the other side of the shelter. If there's any more tent pitches. Let's see if we can get down here. Pea gravel, slippy. I can't see any from here. Let's go back all the way down and have a look. There's a little track here. I don't know what that goes to. Should we have an explore? Oh no, this is the track that takes you back onto the actual Bibbulmun track itself. There's another one over that way. Why did I think the Bibbulmun went that way? Maybe it originally did. I don't know, I can't remember. It's that way. Anything up here? No, nothing up there that we can see. And I was on about earlier, getting down to the fuel station and small shop where the Bannister or North Bannister Roadhouse used to be. here's your track going all the way down there and all the way down. It's about a 15-20 minute walk. I've just seen another track on this side. I'm just going to see if that goes to any tent pitches. Oh, look, are we there? We found one. Yep, we found another tent pitch. It's a bit more like a bowl, that one is, so make sure it's going to be dry if you use that one. You put it at the right angle going across and laying in that direction, you might get a nice flat lay. But again, make sure you've got a decent sleep mat and protection for the bottom of your tent. And that's it. There is no more now. An old track up there, but that is more like a animal track. Yeah, that's a animal track, goes nowhere. So that's the Gringer Creek shelter on the Bibbulmun track. Like I said, if you're going to be stopping here for the night, you've got the noise of all the trucks going down the highway there, so if that's going to bother you, bring some earplugs to deaden out the sound. Okay, if you've enjoyed this video and you're not a subscriber, please go down below and click on the subscribe button. Click on the notification bell next to it and select all so you can be notified of all future videos coming up. And if you are already a subscriber, again, I thank you very much. So until next time, get out there, have some fun, and take care.